Maya Rudolph was an audience favorite during her 7 seasons on SNL for her over-the-top impersonations of superstars like Beyonce and, of course, Oprah. And for characters, I think my personal favorite, Jody Dietz on Bronx Beat.
Oh, yes.
On the big screen, who could forget this utterly horrifying squat scene from Bridesmaids? Oh, just let it happen.
Let's live
happen.
In that moment.
Let it happen. Right there.
Here.
Let, oh.
There she goes.
Beautiful. Yes.
That was beautiful.
I love it.
Enjoy your coffee.
Comfortable place to be.
Yes.
Right in the middle of the street.
Yes. Well, here is Maya Rudolph, by the way. You can catch her in the new film, Inherent Vice, directed by her longtime partner, Paul Thomas Anderson. And Maya plays the secretary to a private investigator who is looking into the disappearance of a former lover.
Oh, and Miss Charloff, I just need your contact information from you.
Look, Clarissa, did Glenn ever mention one of Mickey's ladies? Goes by the name of Shasta.
Girl's gone missing?
That's her.
Yeah. She was in love with him. Deeply in love.
Oh, Shasta and Doc lived together for a short while.
Oh.
Maya Rudolph. Good morning.
Hello,
good morning.
Maya. Good morning.
So this is a dark comedy set in L.A. 1970s, right?
Yeah, and 1970s.
As we mentioned, you're the secretary to Doc, who is played by Joaquin Phoenix.
Yeah. Petunia Leeway is my name.
Yeah.
Don't wear it out.
Just rolls off the tongue.
Doesn't it? Yeah, there's a lot of characters and names in the book that roll off the tongue like that. I mean, it's, well, you've seen it. It's, yes. It's an incredible cast mm-hmm. that fills out all of these characters that are in the book that are beautifully brought to life in this movie, and it's really trippy. And
it's a head trip.
Yeah,
it definitely
yeah.
is that.
And I gotta say, it is funny.
It
I mean, I know it's probably a different funny than people mm-hmm. have seen me be a part of, and I don't even get to be funny in it. But that is kind of funny too. I don't know, but it's Joaquin is really funny. My God, in it and physically, and there's just I feel like the more I see it, the more I get the jokes mm-hmm. too.
Your longtime partner, Paul Thomas Anderson, directed the film. Of course, he directed Boogie Nights, Punch Drunk Love, Magnolia, There Will Be Blood, so many great movies. And he said this about working with you when asked how it was. He said, it was great, it was easy. If you can get a couple of hours where you get to tell her what to do and she does it, I would definitely recommend that.
He said that?
Yes, he said that to the Boston Globe.
What's your response?
What was the experience like working with your husband?
Oh, that's hilarious.
Or your partner, excuse me.
Oh, my God. I'm just reeling from how funny that is. it is actually really nice to sort of play dress up and go to work together, you mm-hmm. know, and I feel like when you're watching someone do what they do so well, it really is such a pleasure. And Paul is such an incredible director, and he's so in his body and in his element when he's directing that it's fun to get to watch. And 2 times now I've given birth while he was shooting, so I don't get to see him. So this time I had our baby, and then I got to go to work and see what he does. Because, you know, I'm home with the kids while he's mm-hmm. off, you know, shooting and in his adventure, what grown-ups do when you're home with a newborn baby. So it was nice to see. It was nice to go to work together for a change. It was really fun.
Did you pack a lunch, or did he pack the lunch?
I packed the lunch. Mm-hmm. I gave birth. I packed the lunch. No, really. I mean, seeing this movie is hard for me because we ended up reshooting some of my stuff. And I mean, I was perfect. It
yes.
was because of
yeah,
me.
Yeah, yeah.
But we changed the location and we had to reshoot some stuff. And we ended up shooting it 4 days after I had our baby. So
4
days.
Oh my God.
4 days.
Kidding? No.
Wow. No, I'm not. I'm not kidding. So those are the things. Yeah, that was the first time I shot it. There was a baby in there the first time we shot it.
Okay. That explains a lot.
Yeah, that explains a lot.
That director has some nerve asking you back 4 days later.
He knew he could get me to do it. But those are the things that you do for people that you love. And obviously, I mean, it felt like a family affair. And it was summertime, and there was this big cast, and our nieces and nephews are in the movie. And it's really fun. It was just a great... I felt really lucky to be a part of it.
Yeah. Well, we love having you here, and we should, great cast. Also, Joaquin Phoenix, Josh Brolin, you mentioned Owen Wilson, Reese Witherspoon, Martin Short, Benicio Del Toro. So you've got it's a huge cast.
I know.
She did the list of that just so she could see Benicio Del Toro.
No, I didn't. But I will say it again, Benicio Del Toro.
It is worth it. It is my saying like that. That is how you pronounce Rudolph, though.
Rudolph. See, there you go. Inherent Vice is in theaters now. Coming up next.
You're on a Russian.
No, I don't know what happened. You know me with my accent. I can't stand on what.